Oh, it was me that didn't have the mic on. Sorry, my bad. I'm saying, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Is your mic on? And here it is. It's all this time. It's me. So I've been chatting away like crazy, and my mic hasn't been on. So good to go. Sorry. My apologies. I was going to see, is Nala Puddin around as well? I saw he was in the...
I do not know.
I don't see him online. But if he gets online, we can hop in. That's bad. Because I can hear myself through the mic, so I should have caught on when I couldn't hear my own voice through my headset. That something was up with that. Cool. So, do you want to look at these maps in Forge mode, or do you want to just jump into a game? Probably just as far as remakes go. I'd rather just jump into them and play on them first, and then do the Forge look through later.
Sounds smart.
Yeah. I've noticed, though, there's a lot of really good remakes that are missing from this list, and we're going to have to start getting after authors to get them to submit. So let's just go custom map.
Do you have a cartographer-only emblem? I haven't seen that one before.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it's not cartographer-only. It's an emblem for having your map in matchmaking. So if you get a map, into matchmaking, you get that emblem. And you get it almost immediately, too, which is really cool because they're really good at keeping up on that. There's a guy, the playlist hit, and then, like, minutes later, he's saying, so where's my emblem? And then it just, like, showed up just as he was asking. It was great. Retribution. Retribution is by an evil Spartan and Smokin' Brit 64, and it's a Damnation remake.
Retribution is not a synonym of Damnation. Negative 5 points right there.
Yep. Right, I should put up my chat. Oh, here we go. Hello. Yeah, the people in chat, sorry about the mic issue. I just didn't flip my mic on. Right, mode, that's the problem. I thought it was waiting to load or something. It's just I hadn't picked a game type yet. Let's just hit Slayer. If anyone else wants to jump in, party's open. So party's open, so we can just I'm gonna make sure the party itself is open. Party's open, game's open, people can just jump in as they want to. So feel free to shoot if you want to try out the weapon layout and stuff like that. As I say, this is my first time seeing a lot of these maps. I know that others, I think Warholic has been through them on stream before, but this is the first time I've had a chance to get through them because I've been focusing on Griffball content and some other behind the scenes stuff I'm doing. But today I'm just gonna go through the submissions. Today and tomorrow we're gonna go through all the submissions and then see which ones I want to help forgers, help them to bring up the snuff. So we'll be doing that as well. So that's my favorite part, is working with the forgers to get their maps working. I mean, to the point where I'd rather be doing that than actually playing them in matchmaking. That looks like a static cam, the third cam. So I should mention that third cam, static cam. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go through the Forge stuff later. I'm just going to do a run through on the maps today. I see you.
So attempting to blow your head off.
I don't remember. Okay, yes. Okay, now I know where I am.
SMG, I'm not sure what that's replaced.
So that's good, they just placed the rocket on the floor rather than on a weapon pad. They've made the teleporters look like Halo CE teleporters. Except, They did something I find very annoying. There's kill volumes in the teleporters, and you know what the problem with that is? You can't play capture the flag on these maps because it'll kick the flag out of your hand when you go through the teleporter. Because you can't bring an objective through a kill volume. Oh, I like the fake covey crates since we don't have covey crates in the forge inventory yet. They've made some. That's not a bad job. They actually look okay. Now it says this map is. I was going to write down the category of remake because there's like faithful remakes, there's remixes, there's maps that have been scaled for Halo 5, and so what I have to do is keep track of which is which. And if they have rescaled it. Oh, they did a pretty good job with the waterfalls too. The steam falls. Rescaled it. Okay, here's a problem right away. The overshield should be set to normal physics so that you can be grenaded. That was one of the features in the original. Wait, can you actually set them to... I'm pretty sure you can set them to... you can set them to normal physics, I believe, right? And wasn't there a ladder here in the original?
Oh. Yeah, there's a ladder.
There's a ladder.
Over here.
Oh, and I like that you have to actually initiate the ladder. It just doesn't pick you up. Like, some people build ladders, you just walk up to them. It's either that or... No, I think if it's not a gravity volume, it could just be the tracks, the slides. It could be a slide, but they place it just above your head, so you actually have to jump into it. So that's pretty good. I like that.
Not sure why everything that is a pickup wreck weapon
is a witch.
I guess it's got lawgivers instead of shotguns. He's got projection SMGs.
Oh, they're all wreck weapons rather than regular weapons?
Yeah. I guess for the...
Oh, I see. Shotgun is lawgiver.
The Sorrow of Taish or whatever it is a bit closer to the original.
Yeah, that could be why.
Instead of the...
Or he just likes them better, but End of the Line is a little overpowered, isn't it? For...
End of the Line is... Well, it's weaker.
Oh, it is? Okay, it's just... It fires faster or something, right?
Yeah, it fires faster each shot.
It's pretty quick.
Yeah. I'd have to compare that with the original game. I don't remember how fast it was.
Yeah. Some of these rooms are kind
right.
of... Yeah, it does. As I said, I was going to write down what the scaling was on each one, but I forgot to do that. I have a spreadsheet that I keep. And what I do is keep down, whether it's a faithful remake or a remastering or an homage sort of map remake, and whether it's scaled for Halo 5 or not. As I said, I forgot to put that down, and I would have to go through and look up each individual map. But I'll just do that for next time when I do my forge through. It looks like you could use a little more decoration or something, because some of these walls are just big plain slabs. It looks like it could use, you know what I mean? I'm sure there's a bit of budget left over. You could use just anything on that wall to make it stand out, just like even putting
down area, the area by the sniper rifle, it's got like the hallway, it's got this really nice red sheen to it and stuff, and it just looks out of place because the rest of it...
I see what you mean. Oh yeah, I see what you mean. Like if you had used
this has more atmosphere than the rest of the...
Yeah, and
map.
Then yeah, and then you walk into the room and it's kind of looks kind of plain. Sheen. Yeah. I just think these big plain slab walls need something. Even if you just put a long narrow block protruding out of it with that's patterned like these pillars or something like that. Just something to break it up rather than a big slab. It might be better. Still looks nice though. As I said, it looks very pretty faithful.
Yeah, I'm not sure if the active camo is normal physics too. I knocked it off with a ground pound. It doesn't seem to move otherwise.
No, it's... No, it looks like they're locked because they're floating. But the original, you could grenade the original.
Yeah.
It'd be kind of nice to see that back. If it's, as I said, it's, I can't recall if you can do it, but I'm pretty sure you can, because I remember on Deadlock, mine used to, when I was forging, I'd knock it about and have to put it back.
Yeah. No, I guess the projection SMGs are where the assault rifles were originally.
Yeah. I think the map's nice. It just needs a little bit more character as far as the plain walls are concerned. But you know what? Let's keep it moving. Let's go on to the next one. There's some real dandies coming up.
The next one.
Cool. Next one up is Unforgiven by an Evil Spartan. Oh, the first three are by an Evil Spartan. The first one was a co-forge. The second two are by him only. Unforgiven. It's, why don't I just start them and we'll figure out what the remakes are.
I mean, yeah, that's,
as we go.
If you figure out what they are, that's probably that's, the first test they have to
Yeah,
pass.
That's the first test
I cannot
to pass.
Tell what the hell this is.
I think it's a cross between Guardian and Damnation.
Slayer.
Whoa, I wonder what this is.
Okay, I'll give him a pass on the name because it's kind of hard to do a version of Hang 'em High.
Yeah. Well, actually, he's got it down. Yes, Hang 'em High, right? Yes.
Support them low.
Yeah.
Yeah, he really loves his wreck weapons.
Yes, he definitely loves his wreck weapons. I think this is another case of being quite featureless, but you know what? I think the original was pretty featureless as well.
Well, I mean, that's yeah. the
I think maybe that I'm trying to
like
think
boxes.
Of that maybe that's what he's actually going for. To keep him very Halo CE-ish. Yeah, a little bit of texture here. And he's got the Forerunner texture on some boxes. And yeah, Forerunner is texture on the ramps and on some of the walls. It's just when you back out, you don't see it, so it looks like plain. Because the Forerunner texture is kind of... Kind of tight. Boy, this map is completely different with abilities.
Yeah.
Jumps you would have never thought of attempting before. Just, okay, I'll just hop over hop over here.
It seems vaguely flatter than it should be. If the gantry is actually this low on the original, or it's just... He's replicated the stupid lip on the trench that always killed me, so that's
the lip's there too?
Yeah.
Yeah, it feels so much smaller with the... Oh, you could never make that jump before. Not that easily, anyway.
Yeah,
Still a pretty faithful remake from what I can see. Let's say, but I haven't really been following the remake scene that closely. Because I knew that this was up and coming, so I never really bothered following it, knowing that it was going to be basically my job at one point, so...
Calm with it being all crazy and it exacerbates.
Can't rocket jump like you used to be able to.
Like having it all gray exacerbates some of the aliasing issues.
Sorry, what was that? I can't hear you.
Just because it's all gray across the map, I think it exacerbates the aliasing issues with the geometry. Right. Like the diving board just shimmers when I'm looking across at it.
Cool. There's some people who want in. That's cool. So all they have to do is send me a message. Hey, something obstructed my jump there. I don't know what it was. Oh, it was a bullet. Right. Cool. Okay, I've seen enough of that one for now. Okay. I was just typing message me to join and he messaged me to join. So let me invite to game. There we go. More the merrier until it gets above 8.
Hello.
Hello, how's it going? There's someone else that wanted to join too, wasn't there? Wait, you're not Stampy Mine. Wait, I can't see two screens at once here. Oh, right. Okay, Stampy Minecraft also. Oh, I see. Wait, you do have a mic. Who jumped in here without... Oh, okay. No problem. Yeah, there's someone else that wanted to jump in as well. Stampy Minecraft. If he's around, just hop in or send me a message or whatever. Cool. Or we'll just jump in and look at the next one, and then he can jump in after that. So, next map is here. Let me move my chat over here so I don't lose it every time I look at the spreadsheet. There we go. Next map is called Carousel. Same author. Oh, go red or blue. Go red or blue, because we're playing Slayer, so I don't know if they have spawns for yellow team or whatever color that was. Cool. How's your map going, Oracle?
Meh.
Meh. Oracle's here. She's usually in the party with me, but she's busy working on her own grip ball. Oh, that's a fast camera. They need to slow that down. Oh, it's called Carousel. I get it.
Oh, not Damnation. Oh, I forget.
The other one. Derelict.
Derelict, yeah.
That's yeah. Right. Oh, nice. He made grates and with the lights underneath. Nice look.
I like using the little space.
Yeah. Oh, the little witch?
Trail. Yeah, there's in the middle, he's just got an open glass to space.
Oh, cool. I get it. That looks good.
Okay.
He should darken the glow.
Got the same issue with...
I think you should darken the glass.
The teleporters, that's the other
one. Make it a little clearer. It's the same teleporters. Oh, with the kill zones in them. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I can see doing that so people don't hover in them and spam in them. But there's a real easy way to fix that now. You use a bouncy barrier, and you stick the bouncy barrier in there.
So if
they run in, it bounces them back out. But then again, you want to be able to run in and teleport, right? So. Yeah, he's got to get rid of the kill volumes inside that. That's kind of cheap. He's also got a kill volume on top of the teleporter, so you can't hang out up here. I'm kind of not a fan of... Let's put it this way. In normal gameplay, a player should never, ever see a kill volume countdown
kill
timer.
Volume.
The only time they should see one is when they're trying to exploit the map. If they go out of bounds, they should see one. If they're trying to exploit the map, then they should see a kill volume, like a hard kill. But if they're just in normal gameplay or an area, like you look like you should be able to jump on top of this and you can't. If he doesn't want players up top of that, he should just put a glass block.
Make it larger.
Make it decorative, but make a glass block or something that looks like it would fit that area. And have it so you just can't get up there, period. Yes, another map that is completely
nice.
Changed with Halo 5's movement. Yeah,
get from the bottom to the top though without taking the teleporters. It's a little too high to clamber.
Oh, really?
Actually, yeah.
I just did it. If you zoom in a bit. If you zoom in, you can, but that's a higher platform there. I see what you mean. If I do it from here, let's see. Yeah, almost. Not quite.
Where'd you do it from?
Oh, I just did it right here.
Ah.
There you go.
Not effective with my control scheme.
Well, yeah, I've got an elite controller. It really helps. There's a part right there because there's a extra piece of debris on the side there. Is it the regular needler? Oh, it's a regular needler. Oh my goodness, what's up with that? Shouldn't it be a hailstorm or whatever?
Yeah. Well, actually, the hailstorm was way too fast. The CE needler was slow.
Yeah, that's true. And something a lot of people don't know about the Halo CE needler is that when you fired it into a mass of flood spores, each needle would track a different flood spore.
Huh.
Like, you could just fire it into a mass, and then each needle would head to a different flood spore. It was really cool. I mean, you'd still have to aim into the center of the mass to do it.
I think this is the best one of his remakes, honestly.
Yeah, it's a little bit of Z-fighting, a few little minor technical forge issues, but I like how he's got he's used the floor pieces or the detailed blocks in some area and the undetailed in others so that the lips are always rounded, like it's very consistent. I really like that. Well, some people just mix and match them and some will be up, some will be down, but he's got it so that they're all basically the same.
And I think the atmosphere is doing more here.
Yeah.
If it's the same simple geometry.
Yeah, I can't really see atmosphere as much as I've got a monitor where the brightness is cranked way up. And when I play on this monitor or when I play on the TV, it's completely different. So usually what I do is if I'm doing an art pass or looking at maps to see what they actually look like, I'll put it on the big screen TV and get a more accurate representation. But everything's so bright on the monitor I use that I can't really see atmosphere. I'll go into a flood map and it'll like, I can see everybody. You know, I can see you through the fog. I can see from one end of the map to the other where no one else can.
Yeah, the pistol is a question. If no one starts with them, then those are gonna be super powerful.
Cool, well let's move on to another builder.
Die together.
Next one is I think you can guess by the this is another one by the same builder. He's got four maps in here. This one's called Sorcery. I think you can guess which map this is. I wonder.
I'm guessing it's a wizard remake.
I think so, yes. Hey, I can hear you. I can just barely hear you.
It's obviously a remake of Ice Fields. I mean, duh.
Ice Fields, yeah, that's right. I think there is an Ice Fields remake. There's one of the ones from the PC version of Halo CE. I forget which one, though. Maybe it's Death Island or something.
The only one to remake is Geraphobia.
Oh, yes.
Although honestly, I don't feel like.
Doesn't that translate to the fear of overpowered positions on map? Isn't that what that translates to?
What, you mean just gonna have a banshee and a platform we can snipe everyone?
Yeah. This map is. He's got it the same really basic foraging techniques as the other ones. I think this is a map that you really need to texturize. You know what I mean? Because the remakes were so involved and so textured. I think that he would need to, like, this center block is just the block. I think it needs this. This is a map that you need to, you know, make use of the stone and marble and every other texture you can, and maybe put some plants and grass and stuff in it and some vines, and it really, this is a map that needs decoration. I mean, even the original one had some texture and character to it, right?
I remember. So it just had the power-ups on the sides, not in the center. Because I've just forgotten that from the Halo 2.
Version. Yeah, I keep getting. I might be thinking of Warlock. Because I probably played on Warlock more than I played on Wizard. And I mean, we played Rockets on Wizard, and that was it. Yeah,
I like what he's got with the, I like the, he's definitely got good use of the skylights. Appreciate
oh, yeah.
That.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I can see he's going for more, real simplified feel to it. But I think this is a map that needs texture a little more definition when you look from one side to the other. It shouldn't look exactly the same. When you look from blue side to red side, it should look different than from red side to blue side. But this, it really, there isn't, I mean, there is slight differences, but not that much, you know what I mean?
Also, I feel like he needs more for quick look. He probably needs more than just the little rotating color lights to show which side you're on.
Yeah, yeah, because I didn't even notice it. It was actually just these little painted lines on the pieces that are the only way I could tell. Where I think it needs to be something a little more defined, saying, you know, when you spawn, you should immediately know which direction you're facing without having to zoom in on, oh, this little splash of paint over here tells me I'm on green side.
Yeah, the rotating lights are mostly blown out by the sun anyhow, so.
I like that he's got the ladder so that you can walk off them. Where some people fail in that area, where if they make a ladder, if you try to walk off, it bounces you right back on, where these ones don't. He's actually done a good job of that. And I only know that because I did the same thing. I was helping a friend with his remake of this, and the only thing I was helping him with was the ladders, to get the ladders to function, and that was in Halo Reach too, and it was really, really difficult to get the ladders to function properly, so that you could walk off them without getting trapped in them or bounced around in them.
You can just thrust from one platform to the other, which is a slight difference.
Yeah. Yeah, this could also be another map that needs to be upgraded to size, because, you know, although it'd be really nice to have 100% faithful remakes in the playlist, you also have to consider, like, we're playing Halo 5, and,
this is not going to work out well for anything larger than 2v2, yeah. Which is a problem that CE maps usually had in general, before you got to sprint and everything else.
Yeah, that's right. I think the idea is, like, my opinion is that the remake should be, you can keep as faithful as you want, but this is the Halo, we need to find the Halo 5 version of this map. Because we're playing Halo 5 on it. Like, it's great to have a perfect one-to-one reproduction of a map, and it feels very nostalgic to play on them, but as far as matchmaking goes, we have to find a map that plays Halo 5 in Halo 5. Kind of like what the devs did with the midship remakes and stuff like that. They, you know. Oh, it's a tough one, because it is a remake playlist, so they can't be too far off. Let's see what else we got here. Like, some of these are scaled, and some of them are one-to-one. Next one, Sorcery. Okay, we're actually on a different... a different one. Now, this one might be a bit of an oddball because, well, you'll see. It's called Wharf, so that should be another easy one to figure out. It's a remake map, but it was submitted as an infection map. So I don't know if I should just move it into the infection. Or maybe it's already been submitted an infection. I don't know. I don't handle infections, so I haven't gone through the infection list. How's our time? Oh, lots of time. Still have an hour and a half, 2 hours.
Slayer.
No, hour and 45 minutes. Bet you he's happy with the last texture pack that we got. He's got grime on everything.
Rusty Shore.
Oh, and I see he's made it on he's made it on Alpine.
Alright, I actually have no idea which map this is.
It's Alpine, because there's the beach is down here. You can see the shiny beach.
No, I mean...
Oh, what map this is? Oh, okay, it's one of the DLC maps. From Halo 3 DLC. And he's not the only one who's made this map. We were actually in, I think, is it? Oh, I can't remember if it was Nullipud. Yeah, you got it.
sure if I'm just turned around or they did a lot of different stuff.
I don't think that'd be a good idea.
Now there's an area over here that needs to be blocked off with a kill volume. Oh wait, was that part of the map? I can't. Oh, you know what? It's a destructed longshore. That's what it is. Because there's pieces of it missing over in that area.
Well, in this entire area here with the landslide.
Yeah. Okay.
Is what's
different. This here where the bridge was, it's just blocked in.
Yeah,
so it's definitely just, it's a floodified version of the remake.
Knocked everyone up. Yeah.
That's a nice elevator.
Oh.
I mean, I definitely like the glacier.
I kind of like that. That's cool. Kind of a cool element, the pipe, the man cannon in it.
Glacier or mudslide or whatever it is. It's cool.
Yeah. I was disappointed. I went out looking for the extender bridge and it wasn't there. It was just a wall.
Yes, it's just a crane than this one.
Oh, I see. It's a vent down here that you jump into.
It's basically the Halo Reach, the package version of Longshore.
How do you get out of here?
Melted into everything else.
Get out of here down here. There we go. What's over here, I wonder?
Where the bridge is supposed to be.
Definitely a pretty map.
Yeah.
The cranes are really nice. That sense of scale.
Wonder how many cows.
It's a little switch here. Does it actually do something? I click the switch. Oh, I see. It just opens
destroy
a wall.
Pellets.
Or is it just lights? There's a switch in the room here. I think all it does is turn out the lights. Yeah, it turns out the lights over here. That's about it. I don't know. Maybe there's something else that happens, but I couldn't see it.
Kind of bugs me that there's no...
Oh, wait. There's a hatch up here. Maybe it closes the hatch. Let me try.
See.
Tells you that there's no what.
Alright, it's toggled.
Okay, I'm gonna go up top, see if it opened the hatch up. No, you'd think there's an there used to be an opening up here, did there not? Oh no, wait, no, this is just the roof itself. I thought there was an opening up here before.
It kind of bothers me that there's not,
Oh, hi, Oracle.
A little animation for the interact prompts, like you're picking up weapons in the campaign now.
Oh, that there is or there isn't?
Kind of. There isn't. So okay. It feels like you aren't getting the feedback you need.
Yeah. I'm stuck.
How did you get in there?
Oh, I just crouched. I thought it went somewhere. It looked like it went somewhere. So I'm kind of disappointed that where the ramp thing across the top is just a wall. Kind of disappointed.
Yeah.
Because that would have been a cool.
Just disappointed.
Well, it's just, you know, that was one of the first interactive elements that were really cool, and now it's something you could do. It's hard to do, but it probably could be done.
Oh yeah, there's a bunch of. It looks like there's another switch here that just turns off stuff.
Where?
This just looks like it's all lighting.
Oh.
Up above the, where the...
Should be. Cool. Well, let's move on. This is one I want to see because this is the map I was going to make. This next one. That's actually a really nice closing shot. Really nice. Sort of like going into the sunset.
So pretty.
Why am I locked up here? I can't change anything. There we go. Sent me back to menu. That's all, not a big deal. Map. Next one is... Mutiny. And this is a map I wanted to make as soon as Forge launched. And there were some other people that said they're going to make it. So I thought, you know what? I'll let them take a shot at it first because I have some really cool idea for this. And I've seen a couple really good remakes of this. I don't recall if this is one of them. I don't recognize the name, but maybe it is. But I had some really cool ideas for this map that I was going to make it back to the what the original was supposed to be and never was. I'll explain it when we get on it.
Boarding action?
How did you know?
Slayer.
Mutiny.
You see, no one's done it yet, so I still have a chance.
To make it actually two ships like fighting each other or whatever?
Make it two ships fighting each other, and one is UNSC and the other is Covenant. But not just that.
Didn't my friend Zoo do that?
I think so. I'm not 100% sure. I hadn't seen a remake
yet. Oh,
we
got another person.
But, yeah, see, this is blocks, and it's... There's a few scripted pieces floating around in space, but they're not really floating around in space. I was going to do something cool. And a lot of people
Might have been broken because it looks like they're wiggling but not actually rotating.
Yeah, they're
rotating
scripted.
Scripts are messed up.
Yeah, the rotating scripts are messed up, exactly. And that's how things rotate, unfortunately. They just go all over the place. But what I was going to do was the original map, when Bungie was going to make it, did not have teleporters on it. And
would it have man cannons?
It originally had man cannons, but they couldn't get them to work in time. So they ended up putting teleporters on because they couldn't get the man cannons to function properly. So originally it was supposed to have man cannons. So what I wanted to do was put it back to the original setup and have man cannons fire you across from one to the other instead of the instead of teleporters. And I was going to also have a few other interactive elements. And the ships, because they're in battle, I was going to make it look like, the canvas with the giant planet? I was going to make it appear that both ships were heading to the planet, like caught in the gravity well and were heading to the planet to crash. And I was going to make the fronts of them all flame-like and then set the winds so that things would blow by you. And then have bits of debris would fly by you at light speed to make it look like you were crashing very, very swiftly towards the planet. Wait, this is the one with the planet, but you see it's not directly in line with it. I was going to make them directly in line with the planet. And then, as I said, have interactive elements that flew across. Now, some of the things that I was going to have fly across were going to be like banshees that were on fire. And I was going to have it so that once a minute, the banshee would fly through the trajectory of the man cannon. So you had a very slim chance of being knocked off the man cannon by a flying banshee.
So you can... I'm not sure if they should have moved things across, because, yeah, you can... Oracle found it. You can man cannon, or you can ground pound from one side to the bottom. You can also jump onto the... slowly sniper rotating girders and get from level 5 to level 5.
Yep.
Sure, if that's like a good update or bad.
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out how to get up again. I'm forgetting the layout of the map. So yeah, I was gonna have.
Well, I think the biggest benefit of having it be a human versus covenant thing is then you actually make it recognizable what side you are on for once.
Yes. Yes, exactly. That was the plan. I almost forget how to get up from one level to the other. I don't know if he's got
replace the ladders.
Oh, with, there's climb ups where the ladders were. That's why. Okay, I'm up to three now. I just the ladder for here is. Oh, I see. They made it so you have to climb. So he probably made this before he figured out how to do the ladders and hadn't updated it yet. That's my guess anyway. So now to get. Okay, I'm up on five. So you're saying you can sprint across from five and ground pound down to one?
Well, you can ground pound from one. But if you get up onto five, you can. Ah, because I missed there. But you can clamber onto the girders and then jump from five to five.
Yeah, you see, I was going to separate separate them so that you could not ground pound from one to the other. And so that you had to, you were forced to use the man cannons. So that was one of the updates.
Okay, sorry,
you
can't go from one to one. You can go from two.
You can go from two to one?
Above two, you can ground pound.
Wow.
You can't ground pound from the first level. You can ground pound from anything above that.
Suicide. Sort of. Oh, right, I forgot to sprint off the end.
Have to be a part of the map on the elevation. Doesn't matter as much just where the right spots hang.
Except I should have aimed at somewhere where there's actually a place to land.
My grenade looks like it's a shooting star. There wasn't a fuel rod cannon originally. Lies! See, get to camp on your girder.
Yeah, I don't remember doing that on the original.
10 seconds to sniper rifle.
You know what? I was talking about that with Oracle this morning. Is that I want to do a big thing that I'm going to live stream from beginning to end, and she suggested a big team battle map, and we had settled on Sidewinder. Because there's plenty of Sidewinders Avalanche. Because there's plenty of Avalanche remakes, but none of them were made after the boost in pieces went from 1024 to 1600. So you can actually make the map now fully, completely, and truthfully as well. So I think that was one of them. But I'm kind of leaning towards this, doing my remake of this, because. Just so many ideas for it that that would look amazing.
I've never really gotten the Avalanche love.
I think it's just that because it was a very good vehicle playground.
I guess.
That was probably it. I think
just the fact that it devolved the center portion into that one.
That's
hallway.
Right. Like, you, the vehicles were viable on it because you couldn't just get into a vehicle and then get sniped out of it a second later. You could actually do something with it, you know, rather than be destroyed instantly. Okay, what's up next? Let me go back to the spreadsheet here. Okay, cool. This map is called Reckoning. And why do I not have it? Oh, there we go, Reckoning. I was just going too far down the list. Okay, a nickel to whoever guesses what map this is first. Unless it was said in the description.
Reckoning.
At least once the name doesn't...
scenic beat.
Yeah, I think he needs to work on his opening can. Yeah.
Well, I guess he hasn't done that
yet. Well, it did say it was a work in progress, so there's probably not any.
Yeah. We also spawn right next to each other, so...
Yeah, I don't think that people should be posting their work in progress maps because you don't want a map to be tossed out and discounted, you know, because it's not functioning or not working.
I'm going to get discounted because it's a Halo Reach remake, and I mean, that barbarism shall not stand.
Yes, if you haven't figured it out yet, it's countdown.
Oh, this practically made it impossible to go down the hole. Why even put the one-way shield?
AKA, camp the lifts.
Well, it's a one-way shield, but shields are destructible, so you can.
No, I destroyed it. Still couldn't.
Oh, so he... No, I... Yeah. I got it down. Well, I almost made it down.
Yeah, definitely.
He's put a kill volume in there again, which I, you know, I'm against, right? I think I've made that quite clear. Oh, I see. There's a bouncy barrier or something underneath it as well. So I don't know why he probably put that barrier there so people wouldn't just keep trying doing what we're doing here. It's just more of a visual thing. I like how the side walls are glassed in.
It's all open at this other side.
A bit of Z fighting. I'm not concerned about small.
He hasn't actually blocked it out yet, fully. Or he's blocked it out. He hasn't done that.
Yeah, it looks like it's still in need of some work. Like these just walls out here that just hang here.
And.
And it's a nice hiding spot as well. But as I say, those are just
get up there.
Those are just little forge technicalities that can be easily fixed. Now I do remember seeing pictures of another countdown remake. I don't know if
there's another one. I think I actually have it bookmarked.
Yeah, could be.
Yeah, I've seen a couple.
Say the main thing is we get the authors to submit them. That's the like some builders don't even know that we're taking submissions, and they should. Oh, unfinished. Yeah, it's definitely unfinished.
I'm so sure there's a way to get up top of these lift rooms.
There's openings at the bottom where you just go down this ramp, and it's not even built down here.
Be right there in 10 seconds.
Yeah, should probably let people know not to post their work in progress because there's a chance that we're just gonna toss this out and not look at it again, assuming that it hasn't been fixed.
Beam rifles on the field.
So.
Beam rifle.
Beam rifle.
Yeah, I don't know why there's a beam rifle either. But yeah, you can just do two-man alley-oop up onto the unreachable points right there.
Yep. Moving on.
Practice your Halo circus act.
Yeah, this one's called Recaged.
Let me guess, it's by something cowboy.
Cyberwolf.
Or wolf.
Cyberwolf.
Yeah, his is too small.
Still looking at it. Kind of my job. I gotta look at every map that's submitted.
Why would you remake this map?
I like it. I've actually got a remake of it. Incomplete, but still.
I mean, it would be interesting from a remake standpoint, considering now you could actually make it look like something instead of just floating.
Floating forge bits, yeah.
Random.
But you know what would be really cool is if he actually made a remake of Forge Island to make it in the same place that it was on Forge Island. That would be cool.
I've seen people doing it with TIDAL. I think you run up into the object limits again.
Yeah.
Or if not object light map.
Well Duquesne is making Forge Island.
Trying to recreate it.
I don't know how far along he's got with it, but he's actually making Forge Island as a project.
He's finished Hammer and Tail.
It already looks better than the original. Sorry, Sorry, who was it that made it again? Was it, why can't I remember his name?
Not Carney?
No. It was, my head's stuck right now. I can't remember his name. It was, he was our boss at the cartographers. Why can't I remember his name? Sorry if you're watching that I forgot your name, but I doubt you'd be watching anyway, so...
Mostly my only positive memories of this are...
It was Irk, that's why. I knew it was three letters. It was Irk that made it.
Irk didn't make this.
Didn't he? I thought he did.
It was, No, it was whoever... That was the whole funny thing. It was whoever made Lockout made this map.
Oh, it was.
Was like, holy shit, he made Lockout, and then he made this map, which people hated.
Okay, then I'm misinformed. Oh, maybe he made Uncaged.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, I think
this is... I don't think I ever actually played the original Cage, so this must be Uncaged.
Yeah, this is Uncaged.
I only joined Reach at the end of 2011, so...
Yeah, you never played Cage.
I know of it only by reputation. I'm not sure what this suppressor is supposed to be replacing.
Where is it at?
It's up here on the lip. Above,
grenade launcher, I think is up there.
Oh, probably.
Yeah. Oh, that's a weird pick, but okay.
Boy, the movement options.
Grenade launcher is all the way over there by red spawn.
Yeah, I thought grenade launcher was over by the lift.
10 seconds to rocket launcher.
Was that
he chose the hydra to replace it.
Rocket launchers on the field.
The double man cannon can mess people up. Your shields are down.
Hostile activity to elbow. Incoming hydra. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely simple, but it's also
okay.
Still
so
way
it
nicer.
Was Chris Carney that made it.
He
made it in one day.
That explains it. Very interesting as a proof of concept, not what you want to ship in a map.
Based on pre-lockout ideas. Yeah, it says he made it in a day. Which is really hard to... No, it's not hard to believe at all.
Yeah. I like his little random grass or tree and garage behind the gate up on the cliff, too.
Yeah, that was where that was made for the opening camera.
Nice.
I mean, structurally, this shouldn't exist, right? Because it's got like four pins that hold it into the wall. The torque on them would be massive. This whole part of the map would be bent.
I wonder, did he?
It's very super tensile metal steel business. Also, hard light. I didn't doubt hard light.
Yes, that's right, hard light.
Rockets in 10.
Also, nano machines.
Hard light nano machines. That's all we need.
Yeah, you can ground
that
pound
jump was
over.
Never
tremendous.
No, he's actually
yeah.
got a platform there to jump on.
Where?
Is that intentional or? Oopsies.
Where is that?
Jumping from center to down where the grenade launcher was. Now has vending machines.
Oh, okay. Shoot. Suicide. At least the kill volume's nice and high, so you don't have to wait forever to die. Oh, what happened? I got bumped. Just like the original, I'm spending more time respawning than doing anything else. Okay, I see what you mean. So that lip resist, up there is anybody. For ground pounding from up here. I'm sure of it.
Yeah.
Yep. Yes, it
okay,
is.
Well, with the plasma repeaters replaced with storm rifles, they're actually useful. Covenant weapons on
should
this
have
Batman.
Held on to your jump button.
Suicide.
Okay, next. Next up we have.
Kind of weird he put that lift there because you don't actually need it to ground pound. Got plenty of clearance to get all the way to the main platform.
Okay. Next is, Atonement. Atonement by negative zero. Nope, sorry. Did I kick you? How's our time doing? Still good? Still good. 2 o'clock.
Slayer.
Pretty. Well, this is embarrassing. We already did this map, no?
You've got the kill boundaries and the teleporters.
Yeah, well, as I say, that's a minor forge thing. Oh, and instead of waterfalls, he's got green slime. Nice take on the original. Even with the sound effects and the what do you call it, like on Truth and Reconciliation? You know, the green coolant that leaks from the spaceship, and that's kind of what he's got going on here. So that is a nice, nice touch. I like the fact that he wasn't afraid to use flat textures where everyone else uses a shiny metal. He's made it down to like a one or two in metalness. Added some nice buttons and controls and things here.
I wonder if he added the secret button to any of these. These are our Forerunner holograms.
Well, yeah, like the original map has that thing that spits out the doll. So we would have to go in and add that in Forge. Sorry, the remake of it spits out a doll. Very nice. And see what I mean about breaking up the walls with textures and stuff like that? He's like filled it in with rocks rather than just a solid wall. He's actually made it look like this is the thing, this is a place, this is where this thing exists. Rather than here's a wall. Rather than here's a wall, it's like here's some structure that makes this look like a real place. Did a brilliant job with this. Oh, and even in the shotgun room, you can see the top part of the goo pit. So it's actually added another elements to. Oh, and look at the walls, the pretty designs on the walls. Sorry, did I just call that pretty?
Yes.
Oh, rocket launcher is on a weapon pad. Oh, wait a sec. No, that doesn't matter though, does it? Because you can knock weapons off of weapon pads. That's right. Ooh, pink teleporter.
Yeah, but I thought you had to use plasma grenade.
Sure. Very nice. Nice lighting, nice look to it.
Sniper rifles on the field.
I really like that he's used the flat textures and the metallic textures to great advantage down here. Oh, and he has the pipes that look like the pipes that bend. What do you call that? Like they're really flexible. That looks cool.
It's not as accurate a remake as the other one.
Nope.
Sure, it's good looking there. Hallway leading up. Yeah.
Yeah,
I appreciate that he's got the slightly purple tint to everything.
Oh, and the ramps themselves—he didn't just use straight ramps. He's actually sculpted them out of
rocket launchers on the field.
Out of rings, so that they round out at the top, and then see the way the ramps round out. It's not just a straight ramp. The doors all have a real cool shape to them.
Yeah, this is really the Halo Reach re-envisionment of Damnation.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It should have a doll that pops out on an invisible switch. A couple holograms up here.
Pretty.
Certainly
is. Yeah, the
lips
to the ramp are nice.
Yeah, I like the way they round off. Oh, and out here, I'm shooting at them, the ones that go up to the sniper. If you look, the tops and bottoms are sculpted so that, you see what I mean? It looks like a real piece there. It looks like, you know.
Yeah.
He's got the arches that meld into, whatever. I'm having a hard time describing things today, but from the tops of the pipe here. Wow. Beautiful. What's also nice is I know that when I go into these in Forge mode, it's going to be much less likely to find game-breaking problems with the maps. And they put so much care into it that you know that they covered a lot of things that a lot of, you know, like escaping and containment issues have already been dealt with.
Weapon pads ready.
So far, the only thing I would change is the kill volumes inside the teleporters, and that is probably it.
I can't blast the invisibility off the ledge.
You can't or can?
I can't.
Oh, so it would have to be set to, I got no grenades. It would have to be set to normal physics.
Normal.
I tried.
Just have to watch you fly into the goo.
Yep, then I got a screen full of goo now. So if you're building a remake, take note. Don't just make it. Make it good. What am I trying to say? Let me word that better. Don't just slap forge pieces down. Think of what you want your room to look like and make it look like something. Not just, you know what I mean? People are still stuck in the Halo Reach thinking about how to forge. Is that you're imagining a log cabin, but you're putting up four slabs of walls because you don't have the tools to make a log cabin. So you just put up four slabs of stone and say, try to picture this as a log cabin. Well, now you can actually make the log cabin and make it look like a log cabin. You don't have to just slap up a wall to contain players. You can say, what does this wall do? How can I make it look like it really is something? It really is a meaningful space. And that'll stop you from just slapping up walls slapping up a wall to make your room. You can actually say, what is this room for? Is this an engine room? Is this the change room? And you can actually make it look like what it's supposed to be. Even if they're ambiguous, covenant spaces, Oh, I see. He's got a the Covenant lift here, and has actually made it so you can see right down into it. What do you think, shotgun area, Carly? Oracle? Right there in front of you. Isn't that nice? I mean, look up.
Sniper heads down.
Looks very Covenant-y. Cool.
Beach Covenant-y.
Well, I get it. That gives me a thumbs up.
Very nice.
Very, very nice. Okay, that was Atonement. So next map is Boardwalk. Let's all try to guess what map this is based on.
It's just called Boardwalk?
It's just called Boardwalk.
Oh, come on.
It's called Boardwalk.
5 points off.
It could have been at least called
like
Walkboard.
Coney Island or do something.
Yeah.
Walkboard. Board run.
Yeah.
Board skip. Plank run.
Board meeting.
Actually, that would be it. Plank run.
Plank
that would
run.
Be my choice.
Or he's gonna call it Exodus. Name off the campaign level that it's in.
Clever boy.
Do cartographers get executive privilege to rename maps?
No, but if I'm talking to a builder, I will suggest Slayer. It. Like, I would tell this guy to slow his cameras down a bit because I'm going to throw up.
No, faster.
Faster, faster. Like, the one that was carousel, it took me a second to realize, oh, it's a carousel. He wants it to go fast. I want some pop. How do I get into the pop machine room?
This is another map that I only really fondly remember from Infection.
Yeah.
I liked it better with Team Snipers.
This is one of the maps I actually like playing Team Snipers. Because I could never get the sniper in regular play, I like playing Team Snipers on it because that way I actually had a sniper.
You should be able to easily do the jump down to rockets now.
Oh, yeah. Oh, from that lip over there? Yeah. Yeah. Should just have arrows pointing to it now.
Does it have a kill boundary on it?
No, there's nothing on it. You can just jump onto it.
Oh, there used to be a kill boundary on it in Reach.
Oh, the rocket area looks nice.
Kind of weird that it's just floating above map like this.
I think you should use the extra 5 parts to have some of those pieces continue right down to the bottom. Some of them are continuing down, but when you look under the map,
it looks like
a forge map when you look underneath it. And all he's got to do is add maybe 5 of those big walls just to block it off, so it looks like it's actually something sticking out of the water somewhere. I got to check out the actual room over here to see what that's like.
Okay, that wasn't there before. Definitely couldn't shoot through that wall.
Where?
Down here at Rocket Spawn.
Oh, okay.
Cage barriers are.
I'll head back down there in a minute. I'm just checking this out for now.
Oh yeah, dude. I guess I'm pissed that I constantly got killed here. So let me put soft walls through it so someone can see who's camping in.
Yeah, that's definitely
not a bad idea. I'm also sad that there's not a waterfall or water feature down here with plasma casters.
Yeah.
I guess the burning trash is supposed to say this was to survive the glassing or something like that.
Just wanted burning stuff. Oh no, yeah, they do have a random fire going on in that building. And they got the odious teapot.
Weapon pads ready.
Oh, I see where you mean, where there's a cage wall here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that should be an invisible barrier or something.
Or at least projectile blockers.
Yeah.
What if we just put shield doors everywhere? Bear with me.
There's a jump that shouldn't be there. Because of the way the light is. What's that? Oh, it's background noise. That's what that is.
Yeah.
It feels like the top center is like really narrow. Narrower yeah, than it was in the original.
And the guardrails aren't as high. You're supposed to. Remember, you could crouch under them.
Oh, yeah.
And that you could shoot under the glass. On the stairs there.
Actually, it occurs to me just because of him. Everyone's been picking up the Spanker rocket launcher, that the weird thing about the first guy who was putting all those red weapons on his maps was he didn't put the Spanker rocket launcher.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, some of his
pieces. Well, that's something. You might want to remove this, otherwise it'll create a pathway that's not in the original.
Where is that?
Up here at catwalk. Top sniper spawn.
Oh, jumping up there?
I just made it just a second ago.
Jump there. I don't remember if that was a real jump or not.
I think these areas with the rocks and trees need to have more like a natural base to them rather than
natural.
Having... Yeah, use the
red.
the small flats.
Weapon pads ready.
And then build the structure up around it rather than having it look like everything's coming out of plastic. It's the right color and everything, but it just too much, looks too much like they're growing out of plastic and that it was staged rather than naturally planted there.
That's too far back.
Yeah, and some of the bushes are growing out of cement. Nothing that indicates.
Also,
that
what is the what's with this random, like, by the bushes? There's the random jump up, I guess. That's what this is supposed to be, but it looks just like you stuck a girder and then forgot about a piece.
That thing you're on right there, Dave. That's the awning.
That was there.
This one over here is actually.
Oh, those
away.
Things. Yeah, there was awnings there. Yeah, they were on the original.
Right, those.
Yeah.
Yes, they are more conspicuous now that they're basic.
There we go. Okay, that was Boardwalk, which is a remake of Boardwalk. The next one's called. Next one's by the same builder, and it's called Asylum. And let's take a guess.
Hey, wait, no. Are you sure it's not Asylum? Parentheses remake.
No, just Asylum. So I'm going to assume that Asylum is a remake of the original Griffball Court. Which there are two or three really good remakes of the original Griffball Court. I made a reimagining of it because the original one got glassed, so I made a new one that replaced it. But there's a couple out there that are really, really good. They captured the actual essence of the of Foundry, and they did a really good job with it. Except he scripted the fans to spin, and they look really, really bad. But otherwise, it's great.
If you put fire on the messed up rotate scripting, it makes it look okay, because it looks like it's messed up.
Oh, like broken. It's supposed to be broken, yeah. Good point. I just put the decal in at the fan gobo. Yeah, this one looks like it's just blocks that are placed. Like this is what I was trying to describe as the Halo Reach method of forging, where you just put blocks to represent stuff rather than actually making stuff. See what I mean?
I mean, that's kind of what they did for Asylum, though.
Yeah, it kind of is, yeah.
He could have artered it up, though.
Yeah, I'm saying, that, yeah, structurally it looks good, but it definitely needs an art pass. It definitely needs, like, plants and bushes and stuff like that, because it... How did I just... What? I just lagged out or something, and it spun me around. Nice. Yeah, so this...
These window pieces he has on top of the things, he'll have to move those, because they cause the disturbance thing when you walk over them.
Oh, yeah. And you can see through them, so you can see players sneaking around.
I mean, you could do that on Asylum.
It looks like it actually. You know what? This is a remake of the Foundry, or the this is a remake of the Reach remake. Because he's remade. He's
even got the cliff wall over here.
Yes, that's right. This is a remake of the Halo Reach remake, because these pieces here are from he's remade the forge pieces, including this little lip thing that was in them right there. I should actually go to the classic remake thread and look this up, but I'm absolutely sure that's what this is. Asylum. No cat. Later.
He's even got it down to the cliff wall all the way on the edge.
Yeah.
All the way out there. Does that mean he's got this one down here?
Reckoning, Recaged, Atonement, Boardwalk. Oh, you know what? I'm out of order on these because I missed the Beaver Creek that was next in line.
Well, he'll have to fix the spot I'm in. Yeah. This could be a very dangerous spot for infection.
What's the problem? You can jump down there?
And you can't get out.
Oh, you get stuck?
Well, I'm alive, but I'm stuck.
Oh.
Throw grenades, kill yourself.
I can't even find the map post for this map. I don't know why I have it on my spreadsheet, but it wasn't it. Unless he's edited it since then. The cat is trying to get my attention, and he's at the point where he's gonna bite me to get it. No biting, okay? Here, you can come up here.
Don't appease the cat.
No, it's okay. He just wants to sit on my lap. That's quite fine. He just wants a nap. Take a snooze. He can take a snooze while I play. I don't mind. I just rest my controller on him and all is good. There we go. You just lay down. I'll rest my hand on you. And when I move the controllers, you can pretend that I'm rubbing your back.
Well, the Asylum definitely didn't have, but the original map didn't have the man cannons up the back of the side bases, right? That was only in Halo 2 Anniversary?
Yeah.
Okay.
Man cannons? I don't remember man cannons.
Or not man cannons, grab lifts.
Oh, grab lifts, right.
On the sides in Halo 2, whatever it's
right.
called.
Yeah. Can't even remember. I'm absolutely Shrine. Sure this is a Reach remake. Like, a remake of the Reach Forge map.
Well, why else
because,
would they have the
because
the
everything's
open
painted
side.
Gray, and as I said, he's got recreated forge. Yeah, Except, unfortunately, I can't seem to find his submission for this. I looked through the thread and I couldn't find it. Yeah, look, he the columns, the Halo Reach columns. No, what were they called? They weren't called columns. They were called
Starliness.
What were these called, Carly? Are you there? Can you have a look at my screen? What was this piece called in Halo 3?
Weren't they braces?
No, braces. No, like brace large and that. No. Can you see, Carly? Oh, you're switching over, right. Okay.
I can visualize the piece. I just can't tell what it is.
Yeah, but it was the Halo Reach Forge piece, and it's the only place where you would see them. And, so yeah, this is definitely a remake of a Forge, of a Halo Reach Forge map, which I find kind of funny. Like, at first, here I am saying, oh, the map needs this and it needs that, and then now that I look at it going, yeah, it's a pretty accurate remake of a Forge, of a Halo Reach Forge map. Like, surprisingly
accurate.
It seems
like it's too large. There's too
like,
much
Like, this is the, platform piece in, yeah, platform or the corner piece, the small corner.
You're supposed to be able to make that without clambering.
Oh, yeah.
It isn't an accurate remake.
Nice.
Can't.
Oh, except he didn't have the one piece that we're missing is the...
The curved stairs,
yeah, exactly, or the cylinder, not cylinders, right.
If you would have used a thick enough curved piece, you could have actually made it.
Yeah, you know what, yeah, I probably could have. Just put it on an angle, have like
you
three
could have
of
lowered
them.
Your object count, too.
Yeah, because you'd only need like three of them to do it. All right, that's cool. Next one's one of the Beaver Creeks. It's not the jungle one, but it's one of them.
Jungle one's nice.
Yes, it is. I haven't actually looked at it in Forge mode yet, but it does look very nice. I've just seen the pictures and YouTube video on that. Right. Yep. I hope I grabbed the right one. He had a bunch of them in his file share. How's our time doing? 2:30. I got time for like two more. Can you see? Cat thinks I'm petting him. I'm just resting the controller on him.
I would feel really bad if I were this guy, though, because that jungle one came out.
Like, yeah, and it's how what's the technical term for it? Fuck awesome. That's what it is.
Although, to be fair, this one is much more in keeping with the original aesthetics.
Yes, it definitely is.
Although, come on,
so the underground part's not tall enough.
What is?
The underground part isn't really tall enough. You can walk under it, but it jumps around.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
And you could put the destructible barriers on top of the bases because the originals have destructible glass. So you could put the destructible shields on it. I saw that.
Yeah, but it takes more than one hit to do the destructible shields.
And they didn't do anything for the water, like no dried riverbed or anything, it's just a gully. Not that that's a huge problem.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's kind of hard to do when you got underbases here, and you don't want the underbases to be underwater.
But you can't use the pretty water, you have to use the fake gobo water.
Running out of time, so I want to move on a little quicker. Oh, this one should be interesting.
What's it called?
Centaur.
Centaur.
I have a feeling it's a Halo 3 remake.
Nope. Older. Think way older. Like before Halo CE.
Oh, so it's not an actual Halo remake. It's just...
No, it is a Halo remake. I was just kidding about older than Halo CE. There's a reason I said that, though.
This is the one with all the teleporters.
That's the one.
And he didn't even
kill
that
shit. Oh, God. Centaur? What does that have to do with anything?
I don't know.
Chiron 3-4. I'm trying to think of the actual name of it.
Cryon T.
At least it's not as.
What's it called again?
TL.
TL-34.
At least it's not as claustrophobic feeling as the original, because he's got those windows and stuff.
Yeah.
That's what I liked about the original.
I will never understand Chiron lovers. It's just like the one Halo opinion.
The reason I say it predates Halo CE is it kind of feels like a map from. From the marathon.
Yeah, it feels
series.
Like a Doom or
it feels
a
like a
marathon
map.
Or,
yeah.
They didn't space out the teleporters enough for the radar to be any good.
Oh, it's the areas you can see each other in areas. I forgot my way around this map. I used to have it very well memorized, but
also really like this. The observation room where you can see down into the center with the.
The
round doors, those are really nice.
Is there a button to move them?
Sadly, I don't think so. Just cosmetic. Yeah, and then you can see out into space in the other hallway, that's nice.
Yeah.
Aesthetically, I think this is a nice map.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Did a good job with it.
Yeah, good job on the piping.
Just wonder how it plays in an actual free-for-all map.
Like Chiron, which is to say horribly.
Hey, there's some. It has some die-hard supporters.
Not horribly.
I know.
Oh yeah, I like that. The
believe they exist.
The orbital windows. Speaking of orbital.
Yeah, that does remind me.
Nice job, though.
Yeah, it's pretty.
I found it.
Yeah, that's actually true. Like, the most confusing map since Chiron is probably Orbital.
Which wasn't really too bad. I find I could never figure out a map until I forged on it. Oh, cool. Now we're in that.
I used to have this map memorized. Is that?
Yeah, same here. Like, perfectly memorized. And now it's like, where am I? Okay, I know where I want to go now. This room here I haven't seen yet. Through here.
Yeah, I realize how bad I am at this because I keep on going through doors, and I keep up ending up in the same places. Now, oh wait, Drew, now I've gone to a new place. It does. He does have these parts where he's like built what look like airlocks and stuff, which are kind of distracting just because you
yeah,
then
you think
want
it's
to
something
like interact with them. You're like, ooh, ooh, aw.
Yeah.
So in that sense, he's done too good a job.
Well, teleporter areas are well marked out. You know where you are. As I say, I'm still lost because I it took me forever to figure out the original. You know what was even more confusing was when I found a map. It messed me up even more.
Oh yeah, those maps are kind of useless. It's like, yeah. Just follow the bunch of random lines. Smiley face on the glass. It's a horrible smiley face.
Very nice job, though.
Yep.
Oh, something fell. Oh, I see it.
Beautiful.
He's got some parts that look like it fell apart out here.
There's a drill I blew up somewhere.
Oh, is that what it is? Because there's a thing that looks like a large dental instrument hanging from the ceiling in this cylinder-shaped room.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Oh, you blew something up on that? Okay. Yeah. See, I wondered why it looked broken.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, right, that's the destructible platform thingy from the rig.
Howdy.
So,
actually,
there's a respawn timer on it, so it wouldn't stay broken all the rest of the map.
Yeah. Ah, cool. Still lost. It's cool.
Found you.
Ow.
So, speaking of... Should be able to guess this one. Nice name. Skyhook.
Skyhook, eh? Static shot.
Yeah, static cam. The cameras are broken.
There's actual interactive doors here.
Let me out.
Okay, is this orbital? God damn it.
Yeah, this is orbital.
No!
Wait, you didn't like orbital? I like orbital. I meant, I like
honestly,
forging
like,
on
I don't
orbital.
I probably only played like 5 real games on it. My worst recollection was trying to get the stupid like the achievement on orbital and just like not being able to find everyone else. We were doing it in a lobby to just cheese it and we couldn't find each other because the layout was so confusing. Like, I don't know where I am. Where are you?
He should have a skull up there just to make up the one that I fell. Suicide.
This is the one where you can go both ways.
Oh, yeah. I had a map that I forged outside of Orbital. It was the most gorgeous thing because the Orbital skybox was phenomenal.
Okay, wait, so there's active camo here, but isn't it down there a kill zone? How do you get back up?
The platform.
Oh, okay, never mind. I thought that was going to block me, but... Alright, that works.
I like how on this map, the red and blue base, you could see into each other. But you had to make your
way around. Yeah, there's definitely some nice use of glass on the remakes.
Yeah.
Is this done by the same guy who did the other one? The Chiron one?
This is, I should have said that at the beginning. This is Uncommon Future, so no.
Just had similar ideas, I guess. Also, they probably shouldn't have made those destructible bay doors that aren't actually destructible.
Can't wait till we get those from Firefight. That would change up a lot of maps.
What's that?
The destructible doors you can Spartan charge into.
Right. Yes, yes, that would be
cool.
These
just look like them. Thank God we got forklifts on this map, though.
Yeah, basically this map, it's a W with an over-under. Like one, like take two horseshoes and stack one on top of the other, and then offset them. That's kind of how it works. See, the outer ramp, the outer one is the stairs that we were just on.
Where's the mongoose?
And the inner ramp, yeah, there should be mongooses on this map. There should be mongooses
the
in the base.
For each base. Can I get that? I'm not gonna get that.
Nice job on it though. And I like that he's forged outside the map as well to match the original in some places. And he definitely put it on the right canvas.
If he would have had the Starry Night skybox, it'd look.
The which what?
Instead of the Ascendant skybox.
Yeah, this is Ascendant, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Of course it is. It's the only one that's up here. I think a couple of these ramps, though, the bottom should be filled in rather than... You know what I mean? He should use solid pieces for it.
It's always fun to attack your teammates and realize how painful this game would be if there was no auto-aim.
Yeah.
Magnetism.
Yeah.
You're like, why can't I hit shit?
I unloaded 9 needler rounds on you.
Just trying to connect the melee is ridiculously hard.
Yeah.
You can turn that off.
I don't... Yeah, you can.
You have needles sticking out of your face.
Just the way I like it. Well, I don't like Orbital, but it's definitely a nice map.
Yeah, very, very well done, and lots of nice decorative elements. You kind of look like you're on a... on something rather than a pile of forge blocks.
I'll have
now,
you know the SS
has this
forge
map
blocks
had a texture
is a fine
pass
ship.
On it? I don't believe it has. No, it hasn't.
I don't think so. I think it's all just the generic.
No,
I think the
author of this needs to do a texture pass on it. I mean, at least the floors or something, just to, you know, give them a bit of depth.
Add a little more variation.
Yeah, right. Yeah, no texture whatsoever. So he hasn't done a texture pass on it yet. So that's something if we're gonna look at this map, continue with it. It's definitely something we'd look at. Sure, but now what do you do once you're down there? Can you get up?
Yeah, you can get back
up
because the Indus spawns down there.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
I thought the same thing, too.
Said that earlier, right. Yeah, so it needs texture and mongooses. Gun gooses. Gun gooses. Let's make this map really fun. Cool. Next up. Next up is... Can't even pronounce it. S-A-C-E-L-L-U-M. Sacellum? Or is that... Sausalium. I don't know.
Something like Colosseum.
Yeah, it's S-A-C-E-L-L-U-M. It's one of those words, if you don't know if it's... If it sounds like
a true word or not.
Yeah, or if it's made up, or if he's got his own spell. I'm sure it's something. I'm just not familiar with it. Come on.
Now, Colosseum Remake from a map that can make real good use of the gravity slides with that multi-level gravity lift.
Oh, that was a... This is a TJ Nutter map. So this is a Halo Gaff map. What happened? Oh, kick me back to menu. Try that again. It probably wasn't gonna load until I mentioned that it was a TJ Nutter map.
Asylum.
Well, the cat doesn't mind being used as a handrest for my controller. This is nice. Comfortable for him and for me. It's kind of warm, though. And I keep rubbing my nose because I keep thinking I've got cat hair up my nose. So every couple minutes I'm rubbing my nose. Did you see this, Carly? Oh, now he's gone and remade the Halo 4 remake.
Of what?
It looks like a Halo 4 remake because it looks like the Halo 4 stones.
Oh.
It's actually nice. I was just kidding about that, but...
I'm totally confused why some trees are icy, some are not, though.
Well, you know, the
pine trees.
Ice melts and sun shining on them. They're different kinds of trees.
And they would be next to each other. They're totally confusing in that sense.
Well, some trees are better at holding the heat than others. It's just, as long as there's no palm trees, we'll be good. I think they're just white trees. You know, this isn't Earth we're talking about.
I don't know how I feel about
Oh, he's got a special thing.
I kind of like using the ice, though, or the glass to make the ice. It's a nice little addition.
Oh, I see. There's a frozen path.
Yeah,
As a Canadian, I feel like I should be walking on the balls of my feet when I'm on it.
I'm expecting that slippery. Blue light bar he has in that ramp isn't in the middle.
It's not? Okay, he's fired.
It's not.
Oh, the red one is and the blue one isn't. Ah, that's it. He's fired. Red one looks good. Blue one's out. Well, you know what? We're going to stand here and stare at it for 5 minutes in the broadcast just so he gets the picture. As I say, that's just a minor technicality. Just a matter of shifting it. Crank, slide it over. Done.
I kind of like having the little holes in the map so you can view out while it's still being...
Oh, okay. I didn't even see that on this side.
Yeah.
And we are on Alpine, of course. He's got a nice subtle snow. It's not a heavy-duty snowfall, which is nice. It does feel kind of cold, doesn't it?
Why
Honestly, the with the hoarfrost on it, the concrete definitely looks like the original Sanctum. It has that kind of halo too, just muddy. This is what it looks like. Okay. Can you jump up to the top though? Oh, there's the lift.
Oh, I like how he's continued the structure well above view as well. Doesn't just cut it off at the top where everyone else does.
Yeah, he's just got some weird pieces. Like, he switches from the stone to, like, this incredibly shiny...
Oh, these marble
dark
bits.
...metal underneath. Yeah.
Rocket launcher in 10 seconds.
Ice fountains.
I don't know.
Or water fountains that's frozen over. That's what it looks like to me.
Rocket launcher ready.
They're definitely a highlight, though. Like, you know what I
You're
mean?
You're supposed to be able to get up on top, though, right?
On top
of where?
Yeah,
you can. He's got a little block sticking out on the left-hand side.
Yeah, but you can't get to it from the other side, too.
Should be able to.
No, I mean...
But you can get up on both sides. See. Oh, there it is. Okay. Alright, figured that out.
Oh yeah, it's on both sides.
Yeah. I think just aesthetically it's 90% of the way there. I just need some touch up.
You did a nice job though.
Like you're saying, like the different colors of foliage would be really awesome if you wanted to differentiate sides, but it's not actually placed where sun are hitting.
That's right. If you had if the sun's shining on it, it should be melted. If it's in the shadow, it should be it should be.
And that would be a really interesting way of differentiating the sides too.
Did he make an actual waterfall, though? Let's see. Nope.
Yeah.
Should make the ice hanging off like a frozen waterfall. I just spawned in a tree. That was weird. I mean, it's weird in real life, but even weirder in the game.
You're constantly spawning in trees.
Well, yeah,
that's some very high kill boundary there.
I don't know if you're supposed to be able to make that jump.
What jump?
That from the ledge right beside you up here. Yeah.
I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter.
I'm saying there's ways of canceling jumps like that so you can't make them by embedding an invisible blocker in it.
Rocket launcher in 10 seconds.
Yeah, well, this is definitely the nicer remake of the one we've seen.
Yes. Very nice.
Rockets are up.
Yeah, there's a few little tiny forge glitches here and there, but nothing I'd really be concerned about. Once again, with these, I see how he's made the steps inside rather than the rings. That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
I'd like to try my hand at making it with rings, though. That would be...
Round. Yeah.
Yeah, either way, they'd be on a wonky angle. Or this isn't too bad with the steps.
From a gameplay standpoint, I think this is better. The other one naturally probably looked a little nicer. But... It's pretty minor. So that's a shame that you can't texture it so it blends in a bit more.
Yeah.
Although, honestly, if he would probably should just have...
Or just make it out of
ice. Yeah. Or just make it, make this should be the same color as the marble, black marble he has other walls.
Yeah, I see what he's going for, though. He turned steps into ramps. So it looks like it. They were originally ramps, and then someone... They originally steps until when someone turned, you know, made it wheelchair accessible.
Yes, it's the wheelchair accessible Halo map.
Yep, that's what it is. He's, you know, he wants to make accessible maps, so that's what we're going to do. All maps have to be wheelchair accessible now.
Aren't you supposed to be able to look down one bridge and see the other?
I think... You mean straight through?
Yeah.
You can, sort of, can't you? Yeah, you can. Not directly, but a bit of an angle there. Yeah, you can see sniper to sniper. I'm not sure about if that sight line's accurate or not, but it looks good. Yeah, maybe it's supposed to be a little more open than that. I'm not sure. I'd have to go back to the original to check that out. Very nicely done. Well, I'm going to have to pack it in now, guys, and finish this tomorrow. So probably tomorrow morning or tomorrow afternoon, whatever time zone you're in. So basically the same time I did it today. We have another... Not too many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 more maps to go through.
Rocket launcher in 10
including
seconds.
Another Beaver Creek. And then after that, what I'm going to start doing is going to start finding these maps that are gorgeous maps that people are sending to me. And I'm going to maybe start contacting some builders, getting them in here. The main thing, though, is we fix that blue light so it's in the center. That's the most important thing to do tomorrow.
This must be fixed. Well, I'll possibly see you tomorrow.
Yep, take it easy. I'm going to shut her down right now. I'm going to head out to the movies.
Take care. The movies.
The movies. Well, thanks for joining me, everybody.
See you later.
Yep, take it easy.